Well, it's not actually the Chattanooga choo-choo. It's the North Shore Scenic Railroad's choo-choo. Getting ready to haul a load of passengers to Two Harbors for a scenic trip. It's an old coal-fired steam-powered locomotive. This, her last trip of the season in its first year of service since being retired in 1959. Somehow it makes me think of the Orient Express. I don't know why, but maybe they're thinking the same thing, and that's why they came. Up in the baggage car is Ken Bueller, a.k.a. the Weatherman. He's the director of the North Shore Scenic Railroad.
Hey, I think I figured this out, Ken. So on the, we got the steam train running here.
She's the 2719, a Soo Line Elko locomotive built in 1923, and she was the last working steam engine on the Soo Line Railroad, making her last trip in 1959. Spent about 20 years in a park in Eau Claire. They pulled her out, they fixed her up, and we brought her here. And she's good until the next century. This is an incredible piece of machinery, a wonderful work of art, a testament to the people that built her back in 1923, that she still works today.
This is a sold-out trip, the last of the season for this old lady. The passengers came from all over. There was a tour group from the Twin Cities, a group of 14 from the UP, and some from as far away as Des Moines, Iowa, all eager to get on board and start the adventure.
So you're gonna take a ride in that train, huh?
Yeah.
What do you think about it?
Really enjoy it.
You ever ridden on these things, these old ones?
Well, not this old, not the steam engine.
No?
I used to ride a train home from St. Paul when I lived in western Minnesota when I was going to school. That was in the 50s.
That'd be fun, huh?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Just go every day.
We've been running the last 4 weeks, and this is our final run today. Now, the engine will be retired over the winter. There'll be service and maintenance on it, and then we'll run it again 4 weekends next summer in 2008.
Oh. The anticipation mounts.
Now,
I wonder if you'd finally get that
one. Get on the top.
Go on the top.
See? It's a double decker.
Oh.
Maybe it goes like this.
Oh,
are they
yeah.
Boarding the train, the bright reception of the conductor is dimmed by the shallow light of the corridor leading to the passenger compartment. Oh, good job.
Where's your video camera?
But once there, spirits were bright and cheery. Meanwhile, as the passengers were getting situated, the engineer was up front, getting ready to roll. There's the coal and the shovel. The boiler's all fired up and ready to go.
Okay.
The train left the station just after 10:30. The firemen shoveled the coal. As the engine belched thick black smoke, and the train picked up speed.
Which way for Upgill?
To the west, you can see the concrete jungle of the big city slipping by. On the other side of the train, the lake. There's the aerial lift bridge. But take a good look. It's the closest you're going to get to the lake. Any closer, you'd be in the water.
Is that a camera?
You're on the camera.
Morning!
Yeah.
The trip to Two Harbors is only 26 miles, but it takes well over an hour to get there. Passengers are free to get up and travel the train from car to car, front to back, but you can't get to the caboose or the engine. They're off limits. But it's a shaky journey at times, slowing at times for scenic sights. That's strange. I thought that guy with the camera was behind me. He must have slipped by when I was looking at the river. Yeah, that's right. One of the first things you notice about the train, especially if you've traveled on jet airliners, is the enormous amount of space the passengers have. For example, take a look inside the men's room. Follow me. Looks like they're having a party in there. You know, I could swear someone's following me. Fun yet?
Lots of fun.
Where are you from?
We're from Apple Valley, one of the suburbs of Minneapolis.
Sure. Taking a ride in the old train, huh?
Yep. Taking up Two Harbors.
Yeah?
Should be a good day.
Yeah. Too bad it's not sunny.
Yeah, well, at least it's not raining.
Tell me about sticking your head out that window.
Well, the steam locomotive, it'll give off cinders, and when you stick your head out the window, occasionally you'll get blasted with some of those cinders. You can kind of see some of them in the smoke there, and it's like little sand coming in your eyes. So, some of the old timers have a technique to get that stuff out. Basically, you pull your eyelid down and roll your eye around enough until a cinder falls out.
Okay, let's take a look at those cinders, huh?